continue. What is this k? It is called as multiplication factor. What is the physical significance of this multiplication factor? It will be like this. So number of nuclides or number of fissions taken place by the given generation of the elements to the number of fissions preceding by the next generation. That means some fission reaction takes place within the fuel, and the ratio of this fission reaction taken place inside the fuel to the ratio of the fissions which are passing through the coolant. This ratio is called multiplication factor. So it is defined as number of fissions ratio between ratio of number of fissions by the given generation to the number of fissions preceding. This is called as k. If this k is equal to 1, if the ratio is 1, means number of fissions taken place by the given generated materials to the number of fissions preceding, is k is equal to 1, then we can say that this nuclear reactor is in critical condition. If you didn't bring this k state to less than unity, not if it is equal to unity, if it is controlled and brought back to less than unity, k is controlled or brought back to less than unity, until and unless if this k value is not brought back to the k is equal to less than unity, then it will be super critical. Because if the critical state was continuous for the long time, this nuclear reactor will shift to the supercritical state which causes to explosion. This explosion which releases the enormous amount of energy in form of radiation which can affect greater surroundings, which is equal to the bomb attacks on Nagasaki, Hiroshima, Nagasaki at the time of Second World War. So this k is equal to 1 is critical condition. K brought back to less than unity, otherwise the nuclear reactor will be in supercritical situation which causes to explosion. So that's why some suitable steps to control these reactions, then only nuclear reactors are useful. Because of these difficulties, many countries are not accepting the nuclear reactor technology to implement to electricity. So that's why this is one of the biggest drawbacks of this nuclear reactor. So this was the case, maybe our Indian country also refused these products in different places. The next nuclear energy is due to the nuclear fusion reactions. Fission, a big one splitting to small. Fusion, already there are two small nuclei. They will combine each other and produces the big nucleus. As well as the release of energy is common. Exhausting of energy is common. Exhausting of energy is common in both the fission and fusion process, no problem. So two small nuclei combined to form a big nucleus is called nuclear fusion reactions. These nuclear fusion reactions are taking place inside the stars, sun and many solar system particles. So because of the fusion reaction only, much amount of the energy is released. But there are some difficulties to understand these fusion reactions, how it will be look like, and we are going to discuss now. Now we'll see the examples of nuclear fusion reactions. The first example is like this. 1H1 plus 1H1 gives rise to 1H2 plus E plus plus nu plus 0.42 MeV. Next example, 1H2 plus 1H2 gives rise to 2He3 plus 1 neutron plus 3.27 MeV. Next reaction, 1H2 plus 1H2 gives rise to 1H3 plus 1H1 plus 4.03 MeV. See the left hand side, two small nuclei combine to form a big nucleus with the release of some energy. Here also 1H2 plus 1H2 gives rise to 2He3, one of the isotope of helium, plus neutron plus 3.27 MeV. Means in these type of nuclear fission and fission or fusion reactions, there is a possibility for the release of excited neutrons or electrons which has excess. 1H2 plus 1H2 gives rise to 1H3 plus 1H1 plus 4.03 MeV. But we can understand one thing by seeing the reactions. Here 1H1 and 1H1, only one proton. 1H2, 1H2, two deuterium nucleates are combining to form a helium nucleus. Here also two deuterium nucleates are combining to form one tritium plus one hydrogen. If these are two same type of nucleates, there is a force of repulsion between them. So the nuclear force is a short range force. But force of repulsion splits the nucleates to longer distance. Means this short range force, in additionally, they should overcome this force of repulsion. Which factor can overcome, which factor helps to overcome the force of repulsion and which is to be valid to the short range force? That factor is called temperature. If temperature is so high, they are thermally excited, and in the excited state, they used to recombine to produce this type of big nucleus, and this thermal energy will be released out in the form of mega electron volts. This is the point we should understand in case of nuclear fusion reactions. So how much temperature it is and what is the validity, we are going to see now. So the temperature, thermal temperature, helps to overcome the Coulombic force of repulsion. Coulombic force of repulsion. Suppose if you take two protons, if they should participate in a reaction, actually the Coulombic force of repulsion is taken place between the protons, and they will separate it by such an amount of barrier. The barrier is approximately 400 keV. Now the energy, which is nothing but thermal energy, has to overcome this 400 keV. So energy is equal to 3/2 kT. This is equal to 400 keV. Therefore, temperature will get approximately 3 × 10⁻⁹ Kelvin. So whenever the temperature is this range, where K is equal to Boltzmann's constant, Boltzmann's constant. So T is equal to 3 × 10⁹ Kelvin. So this much of temperature can able to overcome the barrier of 400 kilo electron volts between the two same charged particles, or two like charged particles, maybe proton to proton or electron to electron. But if you understood the inside temperature of the sun, this is approximately 1.5 into 10 to the power of 7 Kelvin only. Means which is completely less than the temperature which is required to overcome the barrier. So that's why the particles which are participating in the fusion reaction inside the sun, they have more energy than the original particles. Otherwise, this theorem is going to be invalid. So the nucleides which are participating the nuclear fusion reaction they should have more energy than the average values of the energy. Otherwise, this much energy, this much temperature won't be possible. But this fusion reaction inside the sun is a step-by-step process. We can say it as a multi-step process. So now we are going to see that multi-step process with the help of chemical reactions.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.